You give us 3 minutes, and we give you the world. Good evening. I'm Casey Wong. A military submarine that went missing over 3 years ago has suddenly reappeared in the Baltic Sea. Confused seamen mistakenly opened fire on the last Lapland reservation, killing 12. Thankfully, our homesick sailors are back on U.S. soil. Welcome back, boys. In local news, a new crime wave that is sweeping Detroit has already claimed the lives of 21 police officers. Here's a statement from the head of OCP, Omni Consumer Products, that's funding and running the Detroit Police Department.
Old Detroit has a cancer, and that cancer is crime. It must be cut out, and OCP holds the scalpel.
According to our sources, the attacks were aimed at catching the attention of a man whose identity remains unknown. This dangerous new guy in town seems to have his eye on doing business in old Detroit.
Your filthy hands off me! Shut up!
I'm sorry. There seems to be a
disturbance? I'm a big fan. Now move! Don't adjust your television sets. Your regularly scheduled program will be back shortly. Now, this message goes out to the new guy in town. It seems that you're looking to spend some money in this great city of ours. I'm here to tell you that the Torchheads are open for business. You may have heard of us as the number one supplier of nuke in old Detroit. The most potent, addictive drug available in front of every convenience store, school, or library near you. But that's not all we're capable of. Let's get you up here. We'll get Officer Howard to illustrate the point. You see, Officer Howard made a drug bust that cost us a lot of money. We want to reward this dutiful officer with a performance bonus. A lifetime supply of nuke. Oh, man, you're gonna have the time of your life. There you go. Enjoy. New guy, us Torchheads are more than capable of doing whatever you need done in our city. So what is it, huh? Arson, smuggling, drug dealing, good old-fashioned murder. We do it all. You've got the money, we've got the power. So let's talk.
Good to see you, Murphy. Lieutenant's at the main entrance to the TV station.
The ground's shaking. Judgment Day is here!
Hey, handsome. We're here for the show.
Go get him, Robo!
They came out of the trucks and they just started shooting at everything.
I wouldn't bother. I already ran the plates.
You should know by now when it comes
if it keeps on like this, we're gonna run short of body bags.
I'm gonna give you 10 milligrams of diazepam to make you comfortable.
We can't wait any longer. Those trigger-happy maniacs have a ton of hostages. But, sir... Roger that. Over and out.
What is the situation?
Goddamn OCP tells us to stand down till SWAT arrives. That's our situation.
Looks like I'm on the way out.
Not so fast, buddy. Who do you think is gonna clean up this place? I'm not letting you off that easily.
You sound just like my wife.
If that's the case, let's get you patched up. We wouldn't want to get on her bad side. Press here. Medic? There you are, partner.
Lewis?
The hell is going on up there?
Sorry, dude! The police want us to release the hostages! So no hard feelings!
Hey! You can't go in yet! We need to wait for the reinforcements!
Reinforcements have arrived.
I knew you'd say something like that.
We need to find another way. It is too dangerous to cross.
For me. But you can take the heat. Go, I'll figure something out. Besides, you could do with a head start. Go on.
I've got a signet ring. How much do you think I can get for it?
Is it gold?
It was taken off someone famous. Just look at him. He looks kind of familiar.
Guys! We've got company. Anyone expecting a silver freak?
Drop it, scum.
Torchheads will burn you alive!
Worried about the weight limit?
Lewis, you're here.
We need to get these elevators back online. The service box is in the basement.
Let me.
I doubt you had time between all the heroics, but I got a key card from the janitor. It's good to do some real street work from time to time, you know? After you. They sabotage the elevators and staircase too. They obviously don't want to be disturbed.
That graffiti is fresh.
Mm.
burned in like...
I will keep them coming.
What a warm welcome, don't you think?
What a...
Such a big crowd.
I am detecting a short circuit. We need to isolate the cables.
I think I've got something just for that.
You are very resourceful.
Thanks, but I'd say it was a team effort. They're holding everyone in the studio. It's on the 30th floor.
Decided to join our glamorous show. I'm afraid you're too late for my autograph.
Chopper's ready.
I've gotta go, but the party goes on. Guys, make sure you provide all our guests with a decent amount of amusement, so don't skimp on the nuke. See ya.
What a freaking psycho. We need to be quick before they kill anyone else. I know that look, Murphy. You saw something, didn't you?
We are here to enforce the law, Lewis. Let us stay focused.
Right. Just keep in mind that I'm here if you need me, partner.
Slime bags detected.
Just look at that, boys! The police dog and its bitch!
Not sure which one is which.
You're gonna take that back.
Thank you.
thank God you've come. This lady really needs to see a doctor.
Murphy, these people need help. Why don't you go ahead? I'll stay with them.
Right.
This is Lewis. We have rescued three hostages, one with a gunshot wound to the abdomen, requesting urgent medical assistance. Over.
Dress. I'm not sure if I like the pattern. James really looks up to you. He said in school that he wants to be a police officer just like his dad.
Let him pass!
Moves, cop! I'm not dying here! get me another one of those choppers like the one that took Soot! You hear me?
You work so hard, honey. Why don't you take some leave? We all could use a little break from this reality, don't you think?
Wakey, wakey! I'm talking to you, Shiny! Stand back from that door, or I'll shoot her! I swear to Nuke!
I don't know what I would do if I ever lost you.
You got 3 seconds! Three!
Our family is the only thing I need to be happy.
Two! Are you fucking deaf?
Trust me, we will stay like this forever.
One! Last chance, weirdo!
You okay there, Murphy?
What does it want? Get it away from me!
I am sorry.
Can you see? It's unstable!
Ma'am, please, calm down. It's been a very tough evening, and I assure you that everyone wants to be back home with their families. Though for some of us, the night has just begun.
My bail now. Cash? No problem. Do you take singles?
Get back in line.
They're here. Good job, Murphy.
I think you're forgetting someone.
Officer Lewis, you were remarkable.
Soot ran off with his tail between his legs.
Would have been nice if we caught him, though.
All right, all right. Are you done with this circle jerk, huh? Good. We've got a problem.
The malfunction caught on camera provokes a question. Can we put our safety into the hands of a machine? Especially one as unreliable as RoboCop. We asked Max Becker, the head of security concepts at OCP.
Now quiet!
We would never put a defective product on the streets. That's not what we do.
We all saw it hesitate in a life and death situation. Why? Does it really know right from wrong?
Listen, I would trust this guy with my kids. I mean, if I had it. This was just an isolated glitch. Thank you.
Mr. Becker, I've got more questions.
I just want to snap her little neck. But she's got a point. This was not an isolated incident. It's a pattern. A pattern that the old man wants examined and fixed. Time to see what's hiding in that metal head of yours.
We know what's in Murphy's head. It's what's in yours that worries us.
Push me, and you might just find out. You, follow me.
Everyone is dismissed. And Lewis, I need your report on the TV station incident. On the double.
On it, Sarge.
Damn it, when will this be fixed?
Don't hold your breath. OCP isn't looking to spend a dime on our equipment.
There's my favorite walking, talking law enforcement machine.
Okay, let's get on.
Why don't you take a seat for me? That's a nasty scar. I'd like to see the other guy. Am I right?
You do not. Trust me.
Don't mind me. I'll just get this off.
So, here's the deal, Robo. The old man is not happy with your performance. Instead of sending you to the scrapyard, as I suggested, he wants to fix you. Hey, pretty boy. You sure know how to make an impression on the ladies.
Doesn't it hurt him?
Hurt? Lady, he's a machine. He's legally dead. We can do whatever we want with him.
No, madam. It does not hurt me physically.
So we're going to equip you with a little monitoring chip. It will do a real-time check of your systems so we can get to the bottom of what the hell is wrong with you. From now on, your performance will be monitored and graded. So, better be on your best behavior, huh?
The chip is in. Let's see what we have here. Well, I can already see some unwanted activity in your hippocampus. We'll have to keep an eye on it. Other than that, everything seems to be installed correctly. To be sure, let's make a simple test to check that all circuits are in order. What are your prime directives?
Serve the public trust. Protect the innocent. Uphold the law.
Okay, nothing disturbed. However, like with any new upgrade, I recommend visiting the range to check if you need calibration.
Is that everything?
Actually, no. Doctor?
Oh, yes, sorry. My name is Dr. Olivia Blanche. I'm a police psychologist. I specialize in dealing with police officers suffering from emotional trauma.
Emotional trauma? Might as well talk to the microwave. It hasn't been working properly either.
OCP wanted to see if you'd be willing to have a talk with me as part of your evaluation. I noticed that a great deal of care has been put into making sure that your mechanical components work. However, one aspect of your composition that has been severely neglected is your human side, your brain.
I agree. If it was up to me, I'd remove it altogether. What do you think, Doctor? Would save us a lot of hassle.
I don't mind the hassle. So what do you say, officer? Is that possibly something that could be of interest to you?
I am not sure.
Robo, Reed wants everyone in the briefing room in 5. It's about the new guy.
Excuse me, Dr. Blanche, but I am needed elsewhere.
But we...
Well, can't say we didn't try. Everyone get back to whatever the fuck you usually do around here.
Man, I tell you, it was crazy in the TV station. Good job you had, Murphy.
Murphy, could you please help me out here?
I
What seems to be the problem, officer?
Reed is in the briefing room, and I have my hands full. There are so many complaints filing in that I can't keep up. It's getting crazy in here. Could you open up another line and help me?
I am here to serve the public trust.
Take the spot on the podium. You're a lifesaver, Robo.
This line is open. Please form an orderly queue.
Officer, I have a problem. My neighbors are hostile toward me. I think it's because they're jealous of my new dog. Why would they get so worked up every time I take him for a walk?
What is his name?
He has a beautiful red coat, so I call him Fire. He likes to hide, so sometimes I have to yell, Fire! Fire! To find him. Anyway, can you do something about my neighbors?
No, but I will let you off with a warning.
That's fine. I don't mind paying the price for having the cutest dog in all of Detroit.
Next, please.
I got something for you, officer. I know where you can find a wanted criminal. That poster over there says there's a reward for that information. And I want it.
I want details.
Are you blind? I'm the guy from that poster, so here I am. Now, give me the money.
I will have to detain you.
Fine, but I still get the reward, right?
You can hope for a reduced sentence.
That's not the reward I was hoping for, but I'll take it. It'd be good to get back to jail. Life as a free man can be tired.
Take him away. Next, please.
Officer, I would like to report my son missing.
How old is he?
He's 24, but he's never been gone for so long without letting me know.
How long has it been?
Just over 2 days now.
We do not consider an adult missing within 72 hours.
Oh, please, I'm begging you. Something's not right. You really need to find him.
What is his name and address?
George Elkins, 7706 Orchard Avenue.
Let me check. Your son was found dead 2 hours ago.
What? Oh, no.
Thanks for the help.
Murphy, I heard you're scheduled for calibration. Step right up and press the button when you're ready. 50 points is what OCP calls a passing grade. Shouldn't be a problem to you. That's 50. Unless you want to try to break the record, good job. I'll let the eggheads know that you're good to go.
Oh, man. No, I just can't do it. There is no way.
So, what's on today's agenda?
Would you give me a hand?
Agenda?
sit your ass down.
It's no secret that crime has been on the rise ever since what the media has named the new guy in town showed up in the city. The word on the street is that he wants to spend a lot of money in old Detroit, and that has made every gang in the city start advertising their services. We need to find him before things get out of control.
Where do we look?
Our best bet is to see if he made contact with the Torchheads. Robo, I want you to start by checking the arcade downtown. It's become a high activity area for punks.
Understood.
Everyone else, keep your eyes open. Any questions?
Any word on Briggs?
What happened to Briggs?
He's been missing since yesterday.
Shit.
Officer Briggs remains missing. That's over 24 hours since he's been in contact with anyone here.
Are the two cases connected?
No reason to assume so. But if anyone finds Briggs' informant, we might learn something new. All right, now get out there!
You go ahead, partner. I need to write this report, and there's something else I need to do first.
Cruiser's ready for you, Robo. Go get him.
City, didn't you? It'd be easier to burn it all to the ground. Believe me, just burn it all.
Could you please keep the noise down? You're scaring off my customers.
Can't hear you. Music's too loud.
Good evening. Are those two men bothering you?
First, they harass my customers. Then they threaten to burn down my shop. You need to do something about it, officer.
What do you want, cop? Can't we have a little bit of fun? We did nothing wrong.
The music is too loud. My sound sensor measures 126 decibels. You are damaging your ears as we speak.
Oh, man, don't talk to me like that. I don't understand numbers.
Your volume control seems to be broken.
Leave it! That's brand new! I've only stole...
Thanks, officer.
Oh, crap! Give me back my money, you piece of shit!
Don't you cops ever get bored with harassing successful entrepreneurs?
Hey! This shit is rigged!
That's a serious accusation, kiddo. Someone might think I would allow such illegal activity in my high-class business, which I do not. I get lost.
You work for Soot. Tell me where to find him.
You cops are giving me a stomach ulcer. Stop asking me about guys I don't know.
Withholding information can lead to bigger trouble than a stomach ulcer.
Look, I'm a busy man, so I'm going back to my office now. Why don't you join me there, and we'll talk. Oh, on second thought, you can't do that, because you don't have a warrant, do you?
What a douchebag.
With a warrant, cop.
Have you witnessed the owner participating in any criminal activity?
Are you kidding me? Half the things I've seen around here would be enough to put him behind bars for a decade.
Let us hear your statement.
No way, dude. He might be a douchebag, but if you lock him up, this place will get closed down and... Where am I supposed to play hooky, then?
Children should not skip school. It is important for them to attend every single class.
I stopped listening after should.
Such amazing colors. And there's not one, but two of you? From now on, I promise, I will cherish you more often.
Your body readings suggest substance misuse.
Oh, man, a real, like, TJ laser? You are so incredibly shiny. I'm definitely getting more of this stuff.
Who sold you drugs?
I really shouldn't say, but you are my TV heroes. All right. All of the arcade staff will sell to you, as long as you got cash. Unfortunately, I'm broke, but I have a great idea. You could help me sneak into the basement. They keep a huge stash of goodies down there.
Drugs in the basement? I will take care of that.
Would you really do that for me? Way to go, TJ! Is that the ocean?
Open the door. I have the warrant.
Oopsie. I think I dropped my key somewhere. You'd have to break down this hardened door if you want to get in.
That will not be a problem.
RoboCop!
Surrender your weapons.
The jets! Light them up!
Open the door, or you will regret it.
Can't a guy just sell drugs to kids without you harassing him every 5 minutes? Who am I hurting, huh? They all want it.
Where do I find Soot?
Well, if that's the case...
Shut it, bozo! Unless you want to end up in the ghost house like that cop's informant!
And don't you dare open that door, I'll shoot you!
Have it your way.
just stormed into my office. Apparently, his niece's car has been stolen. Find it. This goes to the top of your priority list. You can start by asking about it at some of the local garages. For the record, it's a blue SUX 6000, registered to Melissa Kuzak.
It's a metal freak!
You need to talk some manners.
Metal devil!
Are you the police informant? Do you know where I can find Soot?
Oh, man, all great questions, but could you untie me first? They really outdid themselves with these knots.
Talk.
Hey, I don't know how you usually operate, but that type of information don't come free.
What is your freedom worth to you?
That's actually a great point. So, it seems that the new guy saw the punk's attack on the TV station and decided to meet with Soot on their turf. The meeting is supposed to take place tonight during Soot's concert.
Concert?
I know. I'm not really a fan of his music myself. But that's not what those shows are really about. Why don't we, get out of here, huh?
Lewis, Soot is meeting the new guy tonight at the old slaughterhouse.
Copy that. Pick me up at the station. I'll grab my gear. By the way, I've got something for you, Murphy.
They call me Pickles. And you guessed it. There's a funny story behind that name. This one time, I saw Torchhead stealing a delivery truck. I went after them, hoping that a VCR would fall off the back of the truck, you know? But it turned out to be groceries. So they left it. I made a pretty penny that day selling pickles. Still have a couple of jars laying around if you want them.
So you are an opportunist.
Hey, I prefer street entrepreneur. You know what they say, a good business is where you find it. Nice to be free again. Thanks, Tin Man. Hey, did Briggs tip you off that I might be here?
Officer Briggs?
Yeah, he's my police go-to guy.
Officer Briggs is missing.
Missing? Shit. May our city have mercy on him.
Do you think Briggs is in trouble?
I really don't know. Last time I saw him, he was going to check a case of missing bodies. Sounded like a bogus lead, so I didn't press him. Funny enough, he always tells me to be careful when getting info. But the truth is, I'm not the one running around gangster's paradise dressed in blue.
How do you know Officer Briggs?
We go back a long way. He gave me a helping hand when I hit rock bottom. And I've been in his debt ever since. He even introduced me to his family. Great kid and wife, though his missus don't seem very fond of me.
Need to go. Duty awaits.
About that. I've got a favor to ask. I know that Briggs is missing, but I've got something that belongs to him. He must have misplaced it the last time he visited my crib. And it's kind of weighing me down.
What is it?
It's his wristwatch. Now, I feel bad holding on to it. Could you please give it back to his family?
This is stolen property, and you expect me to return it?
Gee, that sounds bad when you say it like that, but still, you shouldn't let me hold on to expensive things. That's how I ended up in this situation in the first place.
I will make sure they receive it from the repentant thief.
Oh, boy. You're a tough negotiator. But surely you don't mean now. I gotta chillax after all this.
We will proceed with haste.
Oh, for God's sakes, man. As you command, Officer Steely. Hey, Tin Man. Over here. This is where Briggs lives. Let's get this over with. This watch is burning a hole in my pocket. Apartment 21. Oh man, my hands are sweaty.
Are you going into a drug-related withdrawal? Do you require medical assistance?
What? No, I'm just nervous. Me and Gabe. This is it. Deep breath. Let's do this. You first.
RoboCop. Are you here about Mike?
Yes, I'm sorry to hear about your husband.
Oh, Gail. No. This junkie is not coming inside. What else are you gonna steal?
Funny you should say that.
I can't stand him. I'm sure he has something to do with Mike being missing. Are you any closer to finding my husband?
We are still looking. Is there anything more that you can tell me about his disappearance?
I've already reported what I know, but if you have any more questions, shoot.
I heard that he was looking into reports of bodies going missing.
An old lady approached him at the precinct and told him a sob story about how she couldn't afford to bury her husband. Can you believe that? Anyway, when she finally collected enough money and went back to the morgue, only to find that they had lost her husband's body, Mike went to check it out and never came back.
Where was the last location that he was seen?
I remember him telling me that he was leaving his jurisdiction, that that's where the leads were taking him. I tried to convince him not to go. It seemed dangerous, but he felt sorry for that old lady. He went against his own rules and me. He left angry because we'd been arguing.
Do you remember the exact location?
He never told me, but maybe it's in his files.
I think I have everything I need for now.
Knowing you're on the case makes me a little less anxious, RoboCop. Now I just need to break it down for our son.
He does not know?
I didn't know how to tell him. He's a smart kid, and I think he suspects something. Could you maybe tell him to come home? It's getting late, and the streets aren't safe these days. He normally dawdles, but having you tell him should light a fire in his britches.
I will make sure that he returns home, madam.
Thank you. He's playing on the basketball court nearby with his friends.
That went pretty much as expected.
We are not done.
We're not?
You still have that watch, do you not? There is someone who needs to learn. We must get to the basketball court.
That's just around the corner. Are we playing? What's that got to do with time? Is it, like, time to kick my ass?
We are going to remind Gale's son that it is past curfew.
Oh, Daniel. Sure.
Good evening, citizens. I need...
Need what? Some spare parts? Hey, there's a mechanic up the road.
You are not the only ankle breaker on this basketball court.
And that's letting you off easy. I've seen him do way worse for less. Shit, I was just messing with you. What do you need?
We're looking for a kid. His name's Daniel. He was playing here earlier.
Why? Is it past his bedtime?
It is.
Yeah, I saw a couple of kids drawing with chalk they found lying around that crime scene over there.
Thank you for the information.
Congrats, guys. You just became police informants. It has its perks. You'll love it.
I see a couple of drawings over there.
This was drawn not long ago.
Ah, there's more over there.
Shoe print, size 7.
That's gotta be his.
So I guess you have like a scanning thing in your eyes.
Yes, it allows me to see things that are not there anymore.
Oh, so it's kinda like Nuke.
They threw out the chalk here.
Must have found something there. What the fuck?
That was close.
We better hurry.
Do it. Come on. End him.
What are you waiting for? Fuck him up. He's laughing at you.
Hey, what the hell's going on over there?
Yo! Daniel!
Oh no, it's the cops!
I don't want to go to jail for this shit!
Is that a gun?
Oh, you're in so much trouble, kid.
No, it's nothing.
Whoa!
What the hell? You're lucky that Tin Man here doesn't have a real heart. He'd have a hole in it right about now.
Sorry, sir.
You will be once your dad hears about this.
My dad's missing, so he can't tell me nothing. My mom said that he's out on an assignment, but I know the truth. He's not coming back.
Why'd you say that?
He's always been a stickler for following the rules. I guess that's why he's missing. Cops can't shoot without giving a warning, and someone got the drop on him. But that's not gonna happen to me. I'm going to be the one that shoots first. That's why my friends say...
Your friends are knuckleheads. If you listen to them, you're a knucklehead too. Come on. Sit down. We need to talk.
Those friends of yours, they take the easy way out. You don't want to go down that road. It leads to a dark, lonely place. Do you know why your dad is such a stickler for the rules?
'Cause he's a chump.
Because it's the right thing to do. It's not always easy to do the right thing. It takes strength.
And you think my dad has that kind of strength?
Are you kidding me? Your father has enough strength for the both of us. He even helped an ungrateful addict that he found in one of these buildings that smelled of rotting garbage, half dead and covered in vomit. And instead of writing him off, your father opened his home to him because that's the right thing to do. That's strength. Don't you think there's someone else who could use that kind of support now?
Mom.
See, you already know what to do.
You can start by giving her this. She's looking for it.
Is he going to arrest me?
No. It's your first offense. So he'll let you off with a warning. Right?
Right.
It's late. Let's get you home.
Well, you tell my mom about the gun?
No. She doesn't like me already. Thanks for the help, Tin Man. I'll talk to you later.
Hey, partner. What's the status on the old slaughterhouse?
I had to take care of something. We can go there soon.
Sure thing. Pick me up at the station when you're done.